Look back, or should I say, don't look back in anger, is Tatsuki Fujimoto's latest one-shot and his first work since Chainsaw Man ended back in December 13, 2020. The one-shot was published on July 18th, which is one day before the recording of this video. I got a chance to read it today and boy, did it break me. I'm sure everyone did not expect this, and to call this a masterpiece might be an understatement. Some say that Fujimoto has now officially become a legend, or one of the best mangaka of this generation at the very least. This manga caught me very off guard. I expected it to be another superpower driven story by Fujimoto, which he liked, but it was not. It was a very down to earth. While reading this, I felt like it was very close to home for Fujimoto. And not just Fujimoto, but many other manga artists and artists in general. So back in 2017, there was an interview with Fujimoto once he finished Fire Punch, his first very big serialization which he had. And in that interview, I remember him saying that, like people in general who remove their anger, stress and all the emotions on internet via the tweets, like they go and remove their frustrations on tweets, he did not know how to do it. So the only way he knew how to express his emotions was not on tweets or internet in general, it was through one-shots. But this time, I don't think this is what he had in mind while drawing this. This one-shot, unlike any other one-shot he drew before, was 140 pages long. And 140 pages is almost as much as, you know, a full volume of any serialized manga. But that aside, I think Fujimoto took this opportunity to write this one-shot very seriously, not just because it was very close to him, but also because of the events that took place exactly 2 years ago from the day it was released. So, 2 years ago from the day this manga got published was the very unfortunate day of Kyoto Animation's disaster. So, I'm pretty sure you all know what happened in Kyoto Animation Studio. As it was a second year anniversary to that event, Fujimoto wanted to tribute the artists who lost their life, the directors and the brilliant people in that event. So, it's not confirmed obviously, but if you read it, you know what Fujimoto is trying to convey. The way Fujimoto conveyed the message, for me, I felt like, I really hope this is not the case, but it felt like Fujimoto lost someone in the Kyoto Animation event, the disaster. Like, might be his friend, relative or family, or I don't know much about his personal life, but it felt like Fujimoto had lost something more than himself on that disastrous event. We'll not get into that very much, but moving on to the story in general, right? The story, I'm not gonna lie, it did make me cry. I mean, I didn't cry, but I teared up a bit. The story was fabulous, and look, I'm a kind of a person that will say honestly if I don't like something. If I don't like a work, I'll tell you that no, this was good, but it wasn't the best I've read. But reading the one-shot written by Tatsuki Fujimoto this year, it's the best thing that I read all of this year. With no doubt, I can tell you that. Look Back was a very unique take, and it was a very, very different take for Fujimoto in general. I'm pretty sure by now half the entire manga industry has talked about it or congratulated Fujimoto on it, because this manga, as I said previously, was a masterpiece. I'm not gonna go to length saying that, you know, we cannot even begin to compare this to his previous works like Fire Punch and Chainsaw Man, because we cannot just compare it, right? But this one shot, you know, like many people, I am at a loss of words to describe how I feel about it because it took us off guard. I remember when I finished reading this, I read this again, 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 and then again. Because it's Tatsuki Fujimoto, there are references here and there about his life, his personal life, and you know, about Chainsaw Man, Fire Punch. There are a lot of references, so it's fun to read as a, you know, a regular reader of Tatsuki Fujimoto's works. But I showed this one shot to most of my friends who did not know who Tatsuki Fujimoto was, and guess what? They were equally as amazed as we all are. So if you don't already know, a lot of legends or a lot of mangakas, a lot of inspirational people in this industry, you know, express their thoughts regarding the latest a one-shot published by Tatsuki Fujimoto. And here are some of the thoughts which were expressed by creators of various series and how what they thought on the latest one-shot by Fujimoto. The creator of Ore Gairu: no thoughts, head empty. All I know right now is that if manga aliens invaded Earth and their leader challenged us to a manga contest, I'd nominate Tatsuki Fujimoto as our representative. So that, and you get the idea. Once you read this, you know that Tatsuki Fujimoto is one of the most innovative, creative minds in the manga industry right now. The creator of Oyasumi Panpan said, "Amazing, truly amazing. I just read something amazing and I'm speechless. This manga is the kind that breaks hearts. I'm glad I made my debut before Tatsuki Fujimoto. The story was very emotional. I feel like I can't write anything touching like that. So I want to at least draw well. A masterpiece like Requiem Poem, and a lots more than this." Tatsuki Fujimoto, only at the age of 28, just at the age of 28, has already made a big name for himself in the entire manga industry. There are also quite a few references that you might have missed in this one shot, like the character names for the two main characters, Fujino and Kyomoto. If you combine those words, you'll find Fujimoto, the name of the author. The reference where you see Shark Kick, which is a reference to, you know, Chainsaw Man plus Fire Punch. But also a lot of reference, like there is a panel showcasing lots of volumes which the author Fujino released for Shark Kick, and there are like more than 11 volumes, but the last number you see there is 11. The reason there is no 12 is obviously because Chainsaw Man doesn't have 12 volumes. The final volume was number 11. But when we see the end of volume 11, there is something written there: to be continued in volume 12. And we know Chainsaw Man 2 is gonna continue from volume 12 and not volume 1 again. So it's just a sneak peek into Chainsaw Man 2. But aside from to be continued in volume 12, there is another thing written next to it, and it is 189. Now, in an average volume, you have around 190 pages, so that might be just a bit of coincidence there, but you know, if you want to be metaphorical there, you can put a dash in between and it's 189. Ninth month is September, so you can argue that Chainsaw Man 2 is gonna come on September. But I don't think it's gonna happen that way, but yeah, I'm just putting it out there. There are a lot of references aside from that too. Like the reference to Chainsaw Man's The Door, which was beautifully drawn there by Tatsuki Fujimoto himself, or should I say Kyomoto. And as I said, this one shot really hits home. And one concept about it is highlighting the life of a mangaka or an artist in general. Now, a lot of artists on, you know, internet were expressing how they felt like this was so relatable to them. And I get why, because there is a scene in this one shot where a girl in fourth grade, when you're talented at something at a very young age and you can do it better than anyone else, and at one point you find someone else who is better than you and he's at the same age or grade, there is a type of feeling you develop towards them, and that was showcased here very well, and it really resonates with all the artists that want to do well in art and want to become the mangaka of the future generation. But as much as of a love letter this was for all the artists, I think it was more of, you know, Fujimoto's way of expressing his emotions, and it felt like he was telling us a story that was connected to his life. Like, I'm pretty sure we all just felt it in a way, but there's no way of confirming it, and I don't think we'll ever confirm this, but either way, the story written in this one shot, Look Back, or should I say Don't Look Back in Anger, is really fantastic, a masterpiece to be remembered. And I'm pretty sure I'm gonna read this manga every now and then, you know, to just, it's a very fresh taste, you know, when you get Tatsuki Fujimoto's one shot, it's very fresh, it's very new to the genre entirely, so yeah, it's never gonna get old very soon. So I'm pretty sure I'm gonna read it a few more times, a few, like, you know, over the span of this week, this month maybe. And I just recorded this video for my initial thoughts, and let me know how you felt about the chapter, and did you feel like, you know, it was Tatsuki Fujimoto's way of expressing his own life, and it felt that he was trying to express his feelings, you know, his real life feelings, which I'm pretty sure he did. And also, my favorite character from this one shot is obviously Kyomoto, because I don't know, I just like the character very much. And yeah, even Fujino is very good. There are just two characters that's highlighted, right? I guess so. But anyway, with that said, I'll be ending the video now. Peace.